Hello everyone, this is Anand Ranjan, Assistant Professor, School of Computer Application, Babu Banarsidass University, Lucknow. Welcome you all in the video lecture series of Digital Electronics. In this video, we will discuss the half subtractor.
Now we are going to discuss today the half subtractor. Now we are going to discuss the half subtractor circuit. Okay, in half subtractor circuit, just like the half adder, which is used to perform the addition of 2 bit. So this half adder circuit is used to subtract 2 bit. Okay, and then. Now we are going to draw on the block diagram, which will give you the idea what are the inputs and outputs, because this is the prerequisite for designing your half adder circuit or any combinational circuit. So let's first draw the block diagram. In this block diagram, we can say this is our this is our half subtractor. In half subtractor, again we have two inputs, and let's consider these two inputs are X and Y. And of course, in the subtraction, we can have choice whether the subtraction is possible or not. And if it is not possible, then we take borrow. So in that case, we have two outputs, and these two outputs are represented as D, which represents the difference. And we have the B, which represents your borrow. Okay. So from this diagram, you can identify easily. Hello. These are your inputs, and these are your outputs. Now you have to construct a truth table. Which represents the relation between the inputs and outputs. So let me write first the input variables X and Y in this manner, and then I am going to write the difference and the borrow, which required if the subtraction is not possible, then you required borrow. So of course, with the two input variables, there are four combination possible, and these four combinations are 0 0 1 1 0 1 1. Okay, 1 1. So tell me, when we perform the subtraction of this 0 0, then of course differences, what is the difference between these two? This difference is nothing but 0. And to perform the subtraction from X minus Y, no borrow is required, so you can write borrow is also 0. Okay. Now,
yes sir.
Now you can see this x and y. Again, now you are going to perform the subtraction x means y from x. So in that case, of course, the difference is what? 1. Yes sir. But this subtraction is not possible, because you cannot subtract 1 from 0. So what you required 1 borrow, na? Yeah,
yes sir.
So here we write borrow in this column, here in this way. In the next line, again the difference is what? Difference is 1, And you can easily perform 1 minus 0, so no borrow is required. So you here you can mention 0, no borrow is required. And the last, of course, 1 minus 1, the difference is 0, and again no borrow is required. So in that manner you can able to design, you can able to write the truth table, which is actually nothing but the operational, what we can say, the operational information. This truth table gives the operational information of your half adder circuit. Okay, it is clear?
Repeat, sir.
It is clear?
Sir, repeat kar dijiye ek baar. Truth table.
Okay. So what I am trying to say that whenever you are going to perform x minus y in this manner, okay, x minus y. So these digits could be 0, 0, okay, 0, 0. Then, of course, you will get, you do not require any borrow. So the difference is 0, and borrow is also 0. When this digit is 0 and this is 1, okay, is this subtraction is possible? No. It's just like the decimal. If this x is low compared to this one, then you cannot perform that. So the, of course, the difference you can see here, the difference is 1, but what? To perform the subtraction, what you required one borrow. So you required one borrow. When you required one borrow, then of course this digit will be, this will become 2, and then if you subtract 2 from 1, then what you will get, you will one at this position and one at this position, okay, so like this only. Then you will have next digit, this was the 1 and this is 0, then of course the difference is 1 and no borrow is required, like this. And then last combination is 1 1, so difference is 0 and borrow is not required. So the same concept I am going to mention in a truth table fashion, like this one. Okay? Sir, okay? It is clear now?
Is borrow specifying negative?
Yes, sir.
Hello, sir.
Yeah?
Is borrow specifying negative here?
All right. So now, we have output column. One is D, another
Hello,
is D. And now, we are
sir.
Going to write the Boolean expression for these two output columns. Okay, these two output
Hello,
columns.
Sir, take out.
Hello.
So what is borrow
so
specifying? Is it
low.
Negative?
Just wait. Let me check. Yes, tell me.
So what is borrow specifying? Is it
borrow
negative?
Is specifying simply not negative. Actually, if you remember, if you want to, if you want to subtract like this, 5 minus 7, okay, 5 minus 7, is this subtraction is possible? No?
No.
Then what do? You actually take the 10 borrow from the adjacent digit, yes? Then
yes,
it
sir.
Become 15. Then 15 from the 15 you can able to perform this subtraction, na? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
But in binary domain we have two digits only, 1 and 0. So if you take one borrow, then what happened? That adjacent cell will become 2, na?
Yeah.
So now clear?
Okay. So yes, sir. Understood.
Okay. So now
no,
we have two output column.
सर ये इसमें मैं उस तरह तो मैथमेटिक ऑपरेशन तो करेगा ना ये कंप्यूटर ऑटोमेटिक तो ये ऑपरेशन कंप्यूटर कंप्यूटर के लैंग्वेज में वो होता कैसे है
कंप्यूटर के लैंग्वेज में बेसिकली दीज आर एक्चुअली वोल्टेजेस या एंड वी रिक्वायर्ड सम कंपैरेटर सर्किट और चूंकि वो आपके कोर्स में नहीं है हम वहाँ पर ऑप एम्प सर्किट्स होते हैं वो यूज कर उनका इस्तेमाल करते हैं और देर आर लॉट ऑफ सर्किट्स एक्चुअली इन्वॉल्व टू कंपेयर द डिफरेंट वोल्टेजेस एंड बेस्ड ऑन द कंपैरिजन ऑफ वोल्टेजेस एज वेल एज मींस दिस काइंड ऑफ सर्किट्स कैन बी इम्प्लीमेंटेड या बट वी डू हियर द लॉजिकल टेस्ट ओनली वी आर नॉट कंसर्न अबाउट द हार्डवेयर इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ दिस इन दिस डायग्राम बट ऑफ कोर्स देर इज because if you remember that when we discussed the AND gate and the OR gate, then those AND gate and OR gate can be you know, implement using the diode circuit diodes. Yes. So similarly, this kind of all adder circuit, subtractor circuit, they required the electronic component. Those are fabricated using the semiconductors. And of course, in the semiconductor components, they compare certain voltages, and based on the comparison of those voltages, they produce the results. Okay. And yes, in binary domain, we also have discussed in the previous lecture that zero is represented by the low voltage and one is represented by the high voltage if we are using the positive logic. And if we are using the negative logic, then zero will be represented by the high voltage and one is represented by the low voltage. So this is all about the comparison of voltages and mixing of voltages kind of things. Okay.
Are you, sir, half adder or full adder work kisliye hota hai? Uska kaam kya hai?
See, just I told you that to perform the addition, so simply if you are having your calculator, okay, so in your calculator, if you want to perform the addition, okay, so, the same concept is used in your calculators, yeah, because what happened, we will see in the next lecture that there are only two operations are there, addition and subtraction, okay. And with addition and subtraction, you perform all mathematical operations. Means you can perform the multiplication, you can perform the division also. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah?
Yes, sir.
So, streaming is stopped or what?
Sir, aapne shayad private kar rakhi hai.
Huh?
Sir, aapne private kar
rakhi hai.
डिस्कनेक्टेड फ्रॉम सर्वर हो जाता है, पता नहीं क्यों. ऑलराइट, आई स्टार्ट अगेन. देयर माइट बी सम नेटवर्क इश्यू. तो एनीवेज, so this block diagram as well as this truth table is clear,
sir? Yes. Sir,
ha
sir, beech beech mein hindi mein bola kariye, pura english samajh mein nahi aata mujhko.
Okay, no problem. So humne yahan par ek block diagram samjha, aur ye block diagram kya hai, half adder circuit ka block diagram hai, jisme humne jo combinational circuit design mein jo sabse important cheez hoti hai wo ye ki sabse pehle humko apne input aur output identify karne hote hain. तो हमने यहाँ पे आइडेंटिफाई कर लिया, हमारे दो इनपुट हैं एक्स वाई और हमारे दो आउटपुट हैं डिफरेंस और बोरो, और इन इनपुट और आउटपुट के बीच में एक रिलेशन एस्टेब्लिश करने के लिए हमने ये ट्रुथ टेबल यहाँ पे रख दी. और ये ट्रुथ टेबल बेसिकली ये जो ऑपरेशन है हमारा टू बिट सब्ट्रैक्शन का, वो रिप्रेजेंट करता है. अब ये जो आउटपुट एक्सप्रेशन आई है हमारी डी और बी, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू राइट द बुलियन एक्सप्रेशन फॉर देम. ओके, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी आर गोइंग टू राइट द बुलियन एक्सप्रेशन, boolean expression. Let me take it this boolean expression part from here to here. Okay, so boolean expression for d, if you are going to use the minterm approach, so can anybody tell me how we can write this expression d is equal to in minterm approach, you have to write this one output for this one and one. Tell me.
X bar y.
X bar y.
X bar
y. X bar y.
X bar
plus y bar
plus x
x y bar
plus x y bar.
Very good. So now you can also see that this is a standard output of XOR gate. Yes. So you can also write
that,
yes, D is equal to X XOR Y. So now finally you have your difference output expression, which is X XOR Y. And similarly, can you write the output expression for B here for this one? Yes. What is that?
X Y bar.
दिस इज नॉट एक्स वाई बार, दिस इज एक्स बार वाई.
यस सर, एक्स बार वाई.
यस, इन मिनटर्म अप्रोच, इन मिनटर्म अप्रोच द जीरो इज रिप्रेजेंट बाई इट्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट फॉर्म एंड वन इज रिप्रेजेंट बाई इट्स ओरिजिनल फॉर्म. सो फाइनली यू हैव these two expression, this is for difference and this is for borrow. Okay, this is for difference and this is for borrow. And now the implementation, so now you can easily implement this two small expression using the basic logic gates. Then of course to implement this, first of all you require two input. You require two input XOR gate. Okay. Two input XOR gate, in which inputs are X and Y, so that your output is D, which is nothing but X XOR Y. And for borrow, you required a complemented X. Okay, you required a complemented X. So X you can take it from here. X you can take it from here. Pass it into a NOT gate. So you will get X bar over here. Yes. Hello.
Yes, sir.
And then you can take Y from here, and then you can use the AND gate to get the product term X bar Y. So here you will have B is equal to, here you will have B is equal to X bar Y. So in this manner you can implement your half subtractor circuit. Okay, half subtractor circuit. So it is clear to all of you? Yeah.
Yes sir.
Okay. So the next class we are going to discuss the full subtractor circuit.